Hey guys, it's Mikey and Hannah here for CoasterTrack, doing a mini vlog here at the Alton Towers Resort for, yeah, you guessed it, the gardens are open.
So I'm so excited.
Yeah, we've actually left the house for the first time in 12 weeks, which is nice. I'm guessing you guys have probably already seen a few vlogs here from opening weekend. There's loads of good stuff. Topfield Tourist, Jack Siltstone, and
Theme Park Worldwide.
Everyone's been here, but we're here. So we wanted to do it.
Everyone's been here looking as scary as I do in my face mask.
Yeah. So we want to say a huge thank you to Bad Goblin for designing these masks for us. Mine's got the little scare track thing there, and Hannah's just absolutely terrifying.
I'm a shadow.
Yeah, she is. So we are going to go into park. Now, face masks, they're not mandatory at Alton Towers, not at the minute anyway, but we're going to wear them just on the sort of more heavily populated areas. So just here while you have to interact with staff. We'll probably take them off throughout the day when there's no one about, but while we're close to lots of people, we thought we'd wear them. So a huge thank you to Bad Goblin. Shall we go in?
Yeah.
Let's have a wonder. So we're going to get our temperature checked. Scare the kids, Hannah.
Oh God, I didn't realise how scary this would be. Like when I was getting dressed and putting my face mask on, I thought, yeah, it's fine. There's going to be no one there and there's children everywhere. You can't see me smiling. I just thought I smiled at you and you can't tell.
It's a lovely view of the towers with hardly any people, just how we like it.
The bunting looks nice.
Love a bit of bunting. So we are in Tower Street. Unfortunately, everywhere's closed, but understandably, hopefully as soon as shops can reopen like normally in town, they might be able to open these shops. Social distancing, they're potentially opening the park in the thing's coming down potentially opening the park on July 4th. Tickets are available on the website. That's what they're hoping to open with, along with all the other Merlin parks, but we'll have to wait and see. Let's not rush things. Let's make sure things are safe and sound. So far nice and easy to get in, nice and quiet.
Yeah,
so we're just going to wander around. We're going to see what bits of the park we can see, see if there's any rides testing as well. Let's go.
Yeah.
This keeps coming down. So there's not many people about now, so we've taken our masks off. We're gonna check out the Wicker Man, but Hannah's sad.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
It's gonna be my first sober day at Alton Towers.
It's nice to bump into people, is it? Not physically, 2 meter bump into people.
We sort of congregated a massive group of people all 2 meters apart, and then about 5 minutes into the conversation I went, why am I social distancing from this
one? I know, yeah, stay away from me. we live together. But yeah, just saw Alex Crump and ads and loads of people from Towers Time. So yeah, let's have a look at this bad boy here.
Feed the flame.
Let's have a look. And literally welcome to the most boring vlog from Alton Towers, where nothing is happening. But Hannah's got new hair.
I mean, it's the same hair, different colour.
Ah, touche. I see you played Knifey Spoony before.
I have. It's got Dr. Kelman's number on it.
Hello, my name is Dr. Kelman.
Did you see that?
Towers look good. It's a shame we can't go in them.
I really think that that would have topped the day if we could go and explore the towers.
Yeah, if it was like a gardens and towers sort of day.
And if you've never explored the towers, I highly recommend it. Standing up on the roof is phenomenal.
Definitely. There's obviously got to be reasons why you can't, whether or not they can't social distance in there, or a lot of the rooms still have Scarefest stuff in, like all year round now. So, yeah. Will we see a Scarefest like normal, or will we see it slightly different? Who knows?
I hope it'll be some kind of normal.
It's far too early to tell, in my opinion. It's still 4 months away, so let's wait and see. But we're finally going to actually go into the gardens now. We've just had a look at the Smiler, Spimble, Wicker Man. So we're going to go down and enter.
Other rides are available.
Other rides are not available. but we're actually going to go and have a wander around the gardens. Let's have a look. It appears to be a highlight of the gardens opening is that there's water coming from the fountain. I don't think we'll get there in time to see it, but we can see it from here. It looks quite nice.
I love Haunted Hollow at night. It's so spooky. I don't think it's turned on.
So we've decided to start our garden walk with technically not the gardens, doing the Haunted Hollow.
Yay!
Yay, Haunted Hollow, scary things! Woo! So you can't go up that side of
No gloomy wood.
No, you can't go to gloomy wood, obviously. But we're going to do our garden tour this way after Hannah steps on someone's grave.
We've got some social distancing markers on.
Oh, spot on. All right, let's have a wander through the lovely Alton Towers gardens. What's this then, Hannah?
It is the Gothic Prospect Tower, completed in 1824.
And what does it do? I'm guessing you watch over people, over the view. Shall we check out that view? So we're just up there, and now we have found a hole. What's in the hole?
Well,
Hannah?
I've always seen the hole. Like, never I know been... that this is here, but I've never actually looked at it, because why would you?
But... Oh,
it's coming in.
Steeper than you
oh,
think.
Oh, it is, isn't it? I'm surprised Merlin haven't put a fence on this. Spider-Man.
You genuinely actually don't realise how vast these gardens are. There's a Hannah. I found a Hannah. We've literally only just scratched the surface and found so many cool little nooks and crannies, haven't we? If you want to do a photo shoot, like, the gardens is the place to do a photo shoot, isn't it?
So pretty.
So you literally come from out of there and then... Honestly, look at this view. I know we're like a scare track podcast and a theme park podcast, but genuinely, these are some stunning gardens and we just would never normally check them out. I'm so glad we've done this today. So it is worth noting that if you go to download the Alton Towers app, and it'll give you a link to their website where it gives you a suggested self-guided tour throughout the gardens. Now, we've gone completely opposite, because we wanted to go in through Haunted Hollow, but you can still see all the different points of interest, so you can find each, you know, each tower and the water fountain and basically everything of importance in the gardens. Sort of shows you where they are and a little bit of history about it. Just coming a bit handy, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now this is a visual feast for all the eyes. Obviously we've got the conservatories there, we've got a stray Hannah over there. But if you look out over here as well, because there's such a terrain here, what a view. And then you can see the towers all the way over there. You would have thought, why don't they do weddings? Or do they do weddings? Let me know. But yeah, such an awesome view. Look how cool these are.
Giant balls. I wonder how they get them to...
witchcraft.
Like, is it one tree with two roots or is it two trees?
I don't know, but again, check out that view. And ladies and gentlemen, what you all came to see, but without the fountain on. But it does look awesome. It looks really nice. Considering how many years it's looked a bit of a state, it's really cool, really nice, really dandy, eh?
Beautiful.
Right. We're about halfway through these gardens. They're massive.
I'm roasting.
Yeah. It's quite warm actually today, yeah. So let's see the rest of them. You having a good time?
Yes.
It's just nice to be out and about.
The last time I was outside was March, so I think I've just dressed for March weather. Yeah. And I'm boiling.
For the steps. Let's do it. Call these the heavy breathing steps. Check out Topfield Tourist vlog just to see how they coped.
This isn't okay.
How are you coping, Han?
Not that bad.
What? I would advise go the opposite way to what we did.
Don't do the stairs last.
No, do the stairs first. I think the way that they advise you to go, because
it's the best way.
It was just like the end of Gladiators with the Travelator.
I took them at a run at the end.
Yeah.
Bad idea.
But we're back out now by the towers. Going to wander around a little bit apart before we go home. I think that wraps this up, really, doesn't it?
I've had such a good day.
Yeah, it's been nice, hasn't it?
I've seen people on Twitter and stuff saying £12, it's a bit what you're paying for. I'm dying. But I've more than got my money's worth.
I've really enjoyed it.
When in your life are you ever going to get a chance to go down around a theme park when it's closed?
Exactly.
Especially during such a crazy time like this pandemic.
Yeah, it's been great. The gardens are looking really nice. It's all sorted. You can see the towers in front of us. You can see a few rides. Haven't seen any testing, but, you know.
I've really, as well, having been inside for so much, really appreciate how much general public is social distancing today.
Yeah.
Obviously, it'll be very different when they go up to capacity, which I think will be 4,000 for a day when they reopen.
Well, limited capacity. Different.
Yeah. It'll be very different because there'll be a lot more people out. But everyone today's kept their distance. And when we've had to pass each other, there's been wide enough berth. It's been good.
Yeah, breath.
Nice. I am dying. Yeah.
Let's end it there then.
We're gonna
go to Tower Street now. Gonna put a mask on the way out because there's quite a few people around there. Get in the car and go home. But I hope you've enjoyed this very random, very different style of vlog here for CoasterTrack. Check out all our other videos on our website there. And we'll see you soon. Bye.